being. It sounds so interesting. Do you know that over 1 trillion responses come up if you Google well-being? Apparently, we're all interested. Everybody's naming their website that. Everyone has advice on well-being. Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, most welcome guests. Well-being, in my mind, is simply feeling good and enjoying your life. When I was a teenager, I thought well-being meant looking good and being like the women I saw in the magazines and on television. I didn't really look like those women. I had a more square body, and so I became obsessed with my physical appearance because I thought that was a sign of well-being. Oddly enough, that led me to become a vegetarian, thinking that I could stay slim if all I ate was vegetables. I was eating Snickers and drinking a lot of Coca-Cola also, so I kind of really didn't get the whole concept of well-being when I was 18 years old. When I was 23, I got a health report from a physician telling me that if I didn't change my diet, I would be an insulin-dependent diabetic by the time I was 30. And I thought, that can't be me. Nobody in my family is diabetic. But as he talked a little more, he mentioned my deepest fear, which was I blacked out. I blacked out frequently, and I didn't know why, and I had got it checked. And he told me it was because my blood sugar was out of balance. I did some research because I think well-being has a lot to do with awareness and caring for yourself. So I read this book called Sugar Blues, and it explained how our diets in America have a lot of refined sugar in them. And as we consume high amounts of sugar, it throws our blood out of balance, and we have adrenal glands which dump adrenaline into our blood system to balance us back out. Eventually, you can burn out your adrenal glands, and that's what diabetes is. So I decided to clean up my act, get off the sugar, except there was nothing left to eat. I couldn't have candy, I couldn't have cakes, I couldn't have white bread, I couldn't have white rice. I couldn't have pastries, I couldn't have cookies. I had to cut back on everything that was my staple, and I'd already cut out meat and fish and pork and chicken. So what was left? Oh, I guess that's what vegetarian really means. Vegetables and fruit and nuts. So for 2 years, that's what I ate. It was boring, and I felt like I was a martyr, you know, I'm suffering this horrible diet, but in the end, it'll be okay. And actually, in the end, it was. I turned 57 a couple of weeks ago, and I've been a vegetarian for almost 40 years, of different types of vegetarianism. Sometimes where I would eat fish, sometimes where I wouldn't eat eggs or dairy or anything. The most extreme was raw food only. That's where you just are eating raw fruits and vegetables and nuts. And every type of vegetarianism gave me different results, a different reaction, and a different kind of well-being. Now, I think Toastmasters has a lot to do with our well-being, too, because it's all about awareness, paying attention to your body, paying attention to your lifestyle. What makes you happy? Are you experiencing well-being? Are you having a good time? Is your life working for you? Do you feel good? Do you get up in the morning and say, yes, another day, and I can handle this. I can do whatever I want. This is my life, and I can create anything. A lot of times in life, I just thought, ooh, that might be scary. Ooh, something could go wrong. I don't know how to do that. It doesn't matter what I eat. I just like how this tastes, so I'm going to eat these candy bars because I like chocolate, gosh darn it. But then different things would happen. I'd get lightheaded, get acne. Everything we do in life has repercussions. And it is our awareness, our self-awareness, that allows us to be in control of our lives and to create well-being. The road to well-being goes anywhere you want it to go. And well-being changes as you have different facts and information coming in. Remember when they said eggs were really bad and you shouldn't be eating eggs because of the cholesterol? And they shifted a few years later and said, oh no, in moderation, eggs are good. We're all unique. Everyone's different. We all come from different cultures, different backgrounds, different experiences, different metabolism and body type. But you need to pay attention to what your body's telling you, as far as the food you eat, as well as the choices you make in life. Because this is a self-fulfilling universe, and your well-being is something that you have control over. It's just a matter of paying attention to yourself, because you're worth it. I encourage you all to go for well-being, because it's not that hard. And it just makes sense.